10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0.
Before I tell you the regular question, how do you know? When God will turn, do you know God? How will you know? Yes, the churches will say to you, we know it's false, but they will say, this is what they will say. They will say that when God Christ returns, he's coming from the cloud, and all eyes shall see him. That is what a lot of these religion will love to believe and tell you, that all eyes shall see and all knees shall bend, and they will point up in the sky. And I'm really explaining that to you. As I always explain this revelation to you, I always explain it. Whether you believe or not is your business. But I can only give you what the Bible says to give you. I can only give you what God said to give to you. So when they talk about the angels, you know, and saints, we know that they're talking about human beings. They're not talking about imagining some type of angels with wings. That is European made that up. There's no angels with wings. He made that Nancy story for you, and you bought into it. You believe it. There's nothing, no one going to fly around. That is what they are pushing on the people, manipulating language and culture. That is what they are doing. So my question to you, how are you going to know? How are you going to know Christ when you see Christ? You're not going to know. Because all the days of your life, they say to you, when Christ coming, he's coming in a cloud. That is why I love Ezekiel in the Bible. Ezekiel said, I will make your cloud bright. You see, so we understand that is symbolism that he is using. He said, I will make your cloud bright. It's not that you're up in the cloud, but cloud represents darkness, tribulation, problems. So when Christ returns, he's coming back in the days of tribulation, problems to our people that we never faced like nothing on this earth before as our people are going through. That is why some will say to you, they can deliver you. They can save you. No one will be able to save you. Because Satan is in control of this world today. Satan himself is in control. And if Satan don't want you to go from one place to another, you cannot do it. If Satan don't want to give you a certain knowledge to wake yourself from the ghetto and shanty town, you will not do it. He will not give you knowledge to embrace, to set yourself free from the world that he created for you. Satan not going to do that. Because Satan wants you to be in slavery. He wants you to worship him all the days of your life. And that goes for your children and grandchildren. Satan wants you to always worship him. So what makes you feel Satan will give you the key for resurrection? And that is what you feel. That is why our people, if we follow the beast, we're going to stay in hell all the days of their life. They're going to remain in hell. When I say hell, I mean rich and poor. That type of system. That type of understanding. And that is what our people are doing. Believe in fantasies. Believe in illusion. Whatever they say to you. And I'm not trying to be divisive. That is just reality. The European teaching Christianity that lead you into darkness, that takes you into the darkest, into the pits of hell. That is where you are. Because you're trying to grapple with rich and poor, all the days of your life. You're trying to reach on that ladder and you will never reach on the top, because the system that he created was not designed for you to reach on top and stand on top with him. It was not designed for that. He designed a system for you always to remain in the bottom, in the lower part of hell. While he's in hell himself, but he's a king over you even in hell. You understand it. Of course you understand, you are a Christian. So all my question still remains to you. Or will you know Christ? Like some people are reading, Christ will be black. That is the truth. He is African. But how do you know? Because what did the Bible say? Many will come in my name. Do you know much as many? Look at your internet today. Look at the internet today. You see, we have to know what is a false teacher. I don't think because the European teach you what is a false Christ. I don't think you understand what is a false Christ. Let me show you what is a false Christ. And I think you will understand it. Right? You will understand it. Once I show you, you will always understand it. You see, the nation belongs to God. Isn't this right? The nation belongs to God. And if the nation belongs to God, God will send his angels and his saints to uplift his people. Listen to me again. His people from their sin. He going to deliver them. He going to save them from their own sin. That is what it's about. His nation. So let me say what a false prophet is all about. Once you pick up yourself and you say you want to teach the nation, you want to teach the people, you are putting yourself in a position to call false prophet or a prophet. Because only a prophet can wake the nation. And that is designed by God. God will send his people to wake his people up. That is what you got to understand. So when you say you are talking or preaching to help the people, it means to say you are a prophet. You get some message, because it's not your nation, it's his nation. So that will make you a false prophet. You understand what I'm talking about? It will make automatically you going to be a false prophet. If you're not echoing the voice of God, if you're not teaching God, it makes you a false prophet. Because I can tell you things that before the Bible was written. I can show you things before the scripture was written to give to man. You see? But many of us don't understand that. So that is why I stick to the Bible to you. I don't go beyond that. And to make you know that God has sent someone for you all the time. God never leave a nation without a prophet. God never leaves his people without someone to direct you in the right footsteps. Into the way of God. He will never leave you without water. He will never leave you hungry. He will never leave you thirsty. That is why he said, do not go in the desert looking for Christ. That is what a lot of us is doing. We are in the desert looking for Christ. We are in the desert because we don't know the image of God when we see God. Some of us Christian, we still see Christ as a European. in all their magazines. Their magazines will portray Christ, depict Christ as a European, and they're satisfied with that. Depict Christ as blue-eyed, and they're satisfied with that. That should show you don't know nothing about God. You don't see the face of God. So what will you look for in the last days? You will look for a blue-eyed Jesus. Because you cannot believe when you see God. That is why when people see the truth, they turn away. They say, no, this cannot be the truth. How can this man be Christ? That is what they say. You remember the Pharisees? The Pharisees say, is this Christ? They say, yes. This is the was talking amongst himself. They say, look, Christ here, the carpenter's son. The Pharisees say, wait a minute, this can never be Christ. Because their expectation of God is wrong. Are your expectations today wrong? Of course it's wrong. I can tell you, if you sit in the Seventh-day Adventist Church, your expectation of God is wrong. If you're sitting in the Seventh-day Adventist Church, of course, Pentecostal, Catholic, I can tell you, your expectation is wrong. That what God is going to return as, go look on the television, and all you seeing is what you call their image. Oh, they depict Christ as blue eye. That is what many people are looking for. And some are saying, will Christ have no face? What nonsense. Some will even say that to you. But yet they can point out the Antichrist. How is it that you can show us the devil, but you cannot show us God? This goes for Seventh-day Adventists also. Especially Seventh-day Adventists, because they will talk about the Pope, and the Pope is the devil. Well, if you can tell me who is the devil, well, show me God. But they cannot. They will not show you God because they don't know. Like many of those religions outside here, they cannot point out God to you because they don't know God, and they don't know how to point out God to you. But I'm saying to my people, if you know the feelings of God, you will know when you see God. If you have the character of God, you will know God. That is some of the things going to make you know, let you know that it's God that you're dealing with. Then the sheep heard the voice and know the voice. Why is it today that you don't know the voice of God? What did Christ say? You can tell when it's going to rain. You can tell of these things. But when it comes to know your God, you don't know. You are a hypocrite. That is what the Father let us know. You can know all of these things. But when it comes to Christ, you don't know. You are playing games because you cannot stand to see that God is going to be in flesh. And you are not that. Envy and jealousy takes the people once again. You don't know how not to envy your brother. You don't know how not to do that because of false ideology. Do you see the duplicity in your ways? That you don't know Christ when you see Christ. Do you understand that whether maybe you are just lethargic to the truth? And if you are lethargic or indolent, well, you will be forgiven. Automatically you will be forgiven if you're indolent, if you're lazy and you're slow. Deadly combination, lazy and slow-minded people, it's all right. But I'm not talking about that. I'm talking about the people who go around talking about they know God and they know what God looks like. How can you preach something that you don't know? This is my question to these religious, so-called religious people outside here. How can you know God? How can you preach Let me say it again. How can you preach the words of God and you don't know God? How can you love if you don't know love? You cannot say you're educated when you're not. You'll be a fooler. You're a fool in the nation. So that is why I say it to you. This is the reason I said it to you. False prophets. Many Christs. False Christs. And that is what's going on in our society. And it's not coming from Washington. It's not coming from London. It's not coming from Chicago. It's coming from within the churches. It's coming from the churches. And even though, as I always say, you may read the Bible, you may not call yourself Christian, but you are doing the same. You don't know God. Before you preach, you must know the voice of God. If any of you are listening, can you say you know God, but you are sitting in the churches for 30 and 40 years and you still don't understand the scripture, you still don't understand the Bible, that the scripture, the Bible must provision us to God and God alone. That is what it's about. Let the words take you, wrap you into God forever and ever. So we're going to come back. We're going to talk more about knowing God. It's not too late. It's never too late to know God. I don't want you sitting in the churches saying you don't know or no one knows. That is not the truth. It's a lie. All right? So let's do this. Let's do this right here on Visionary Talk Radio. This is how we do it all the time. All the time on Visionary Talk Radio. Gonna play this beautiful song right here for you guys. Right here. All right? Let's do some love.